was sitting up there and I wanted to come down a bit lower. The thing is, it mightn't work with it being a different size to the other two daisies. So do you see where I've put it there now? I'll give that a shot next. I'm a bit disappointed in myself for the really clear demonstration I was going to give, and I think it's just a bit too clear in comparison to the rest of it. Don't know if I wanted to have a level of clarity, you know. I don't even like the shape of the stem either, that's annoying me. Maybe it needs to sit somewhere slightly different. Maybe because the daisy itself isn't annoying me. I like the daisy, I just don't like it as part of my painting so far. I have a sense that I'm going to have to do this demonstration again too, because I'm, you know, it's not, I wasn't meaning to sell a kind of a giving out to myself. Video. I wasn't meaning to make that kind of a video. There we are, so that's that. Right, now, there'll be redemption yet. You'll see that something will happen and I think, oh, it's okay. Everything's okay again. It's like life. Alright, so let me just ignore that for a minute now and we'll go up here. And I'd aim to explain this poor little daisy on the way up to the other one. Well, right, so the centre of that now is a kind of cadmium yellow. And so I'm going to put the centre on anyway first. Maybe a thumbprint of yellow. Fingerprint of yellow even. Kind of here, I should say. Even lower. Right there. I'll bring you in close again now because you're far away from this little one. Sorry for the shake. Okay. And now with half closed eyes, I'll just explain what I think is the shape of the area of petals there. There's a few sticking out this way and then coming up kind of straight for a while. And then there's like a kind of a pincer shape with these two coming out here. And then in between them there's another one that extends down the way like that. And then they kind of shoot off in that direction. But it's quite grey there, so I'm not going to paint white only there. And then there's a one that catches the light here again. I'll get another brush so that I have the option of putting on the greyish coloured petals. Here. I'm making a grey that's a bit greeny, purpley or something. It's just, I suppose you might call it a French grey or something. I'm kind of struggling to find exactly what that grey is called, but I'm happy enough with the colour I've achieved here for it. Just stand back and have a look. Yeah, it's okay. Seems to be offering some redemption. And that same grey sits back there. So the grey, I made it with Payne's grey, lemon yellow and some white. Haynes grey, lemon yellow, and some white. You kind of think the daisy petals are all white, but actually when you look closely at them, the brightest ones are only reading as being that bright because next to them or behind them is a very dark grey one. Maybe not very dark, but you know, in the scheme of things, you wouldn't call it white. And there's one that's, I love that it's kind of half, it's half dishevelled looking, this daisy, on its last legs, but also beautiful for it, kind of papery. Go back to the white again now to do the overlapping. And then it's good too to keep a radar up for when enough is done, because you might end up feeling like you need to explain every single petal, when actually for your painting it's a wiser decision to maybe leave it unfinished. Okay. And there's some really bright ones up there too. And a channel of brightness coming down there. It's gonna place it, hopefully. It's a bit too thick. I think I'll get away with it. There's a couple of petals sitting in front of the yellow here, but actually not, I don't think it's going to help me to paint them in. I'm not so fussed about painting them in for some reason. The white along the rim there, it's kind of shining in the light. And